recycles end-of-life electronics. What our mission is and what we're really doing is developing innovative solutions that reduces the amount of old electronics that go into landfill and allows us to recover material from those or allows us to refurbish them and resell them. Urban Mining was founded by Juan Carlos Villatoro. He enrolled at UNF with one mission, to learn as much as he could about building an electronics recycling business.
I was born in El Salvador, and my dad owned an aluminum foundry. The aluminum extracted its heat from melting out of burnt engine oil. My father never really took the approach to managing the giant black clouds that generated from the burning oil. My father was a big influence on my interest towards the metal industry. At the same time, he was the biggest influence towards me having a responsibility and duty to see if I can spend my days to make our planet a better place than I found it.
We take electronics in from residential customers as a community service at no charge, and most of the electronics that we bring in are from larger corporate enterprise clients. If you think about electronics, it's really a big problem. It's getting bigger as the life cycle of products decrease and the amount of electronics that are part of the business environment continues to increase. If you think about end-of-life electronics, if you think about, you know, all those computers today, it's the largest single waste stream going into landfills. When we think about reducing the amount of electronic waste, it's really impacting our most local community, diverting all of those electronics and the toxins that are associated with them from what's getting dumped here. You know, on one hand, it's reducing the impact on a landfill, and on the other, a big part of our process is refurbishing this equipment back to OEM standards and then reselling it to the consumer market at a great discount. When we bring that equipment in, it's all evaluated, and one of two things happen. The primary goal is to see if that equipment can be repaired, refurbished, and resold. In that case, everything is individually tested and resold and warrantied. If it can't be refurbished and resold, then it goes in the other direction to what we call the scrap process. In that process, everything is demanufactured, and then all of the components are sold off back into the manufacturing stream. So our process is really what we call net zero. Nothing that moves through our plant ends up going into a landfill. There are a couple of ways that we're actively involved with the community. The majority of our employees have come from an organization called Lutheran Social Services that helps displaced refugees. We've got people from five different countries speaking three or four different languages and learning a skill working for a technology company that really, I think, adds value to them personally and pays them a living wage. The other things that we do to support the community is our retail tech shop, where we resell refurbished equipment and offer service and repair. And the third thing, which is a program that we just developed with the Duval County Public School System that will allow us to take all of the electronics that come out of the Duval County Public Schools and, once we get it refurbished, sell it back to students at a 50% discount from retail pricing. The school district, along with us, have made a real commitment to take all of this IT, laptops, desktops, and help get it into the hands of students who can really use it at a great value.
My message to the general public or individuals that are in business, take a careful look at what you're doing with the end-of-life electronics. Many businesses think that safeguarding the front end of the store is the route to keep their business safe, but I happen to see many companies that ignore the section of disposal of electronics, and so much data is left behind. Because for you, it might not be useful, but there's a lot of people that will use that data for the wrong purposes.
Oftentimes, hackers can get information off of disposed of computers that will then give them what they need to kind of help a frontal assault. Whether it's residential, where we don't charge, or from an enterprise client, everything is brought in, it's securely stored until it goes through a process where the hard drives are completely destroyed or wiped to DoD level standards so that there's no data left on them at all. Every day we're all about new and innovative approaches to take all of those used electronics and find a way to avoid having them go into a landfill so they can be repurposed and reused.
I strongly believe that it is possible to be technologically advanced and at the same time to live in harmony with the natural world.